In this vlog, we will try to see the implementation of reaches button using WhatsApp. So in your application, whenever you want user to reach you back with any query, so you can just add a reach button. And now we will be supporting this reach button with the help of WhatsApp. So whenever you tap on this particular button, WhatsApp will be opened in your device and will be redirected to that particular contact number and also a predefined message. So nowadays WhatsApp is providing a business account option. So if you are having any business account and you want to integrate that account in your application, so this tutorial is for you. So let's go through this entire tutorial for more information on how we can integrate feedback or contact option using WhatsApp in your application. So now the first prerequisite is we need to add a URL launcher here. So I'm going to add a URL launcher under the dependencies here, and I have specified this particular version, and make sure you provide the latest version available. So now let's start with our basic coding. I'm importing the material.dart, and inside the void main I'm going to specify run app, and inside which we are going to specify my app. And now I'm going to consider a stateless widget my app, and this one will going to return a material app, so inside which specify the scaffold in home. And also we need an app bar and provide a title here. So with the help of a text widget we can specify some title here. So I'm just specifying like contact us. And also we are going to specify body over here, and I'm going to consider a container. So specifically I don't have any other widgets here, I just want to specify one text button. So for this text button we have two parameters like onPress and child. So these two are the compulsory parameters you need to specify. And inside the text I'm going to specify a text like reaches. You can also specify your own customized text over here, and also you can add any icons to make it much easier for user to understand. So inside the onPress we are going to create a method. So here I'm going to create a reach us kind of method here. You can also add your own name, and this is of a type async, so this will work asynchronously on background. And as we need to open the WhatsApp and we need to provide the pre-written text, so these things should be done asynchronously in background. So now let's specify the contact number. So here I'm going to just specify any basic number, but while you are implementing this, make sure you specify the actual number so that the user can reach to this particular number when they tap on the reaches button. And also we have one more variable like Android URL. So with the help of this URL we are going to open the WhatsApp in Android device. So we are going to specify this URL here, and you need to append the contact here, and also you need to specify here the text. So I just want to specify hi, I need some help. So this is what some information I want to let the user know so that he can respond back now. And make sure you provide this URL as it is, so that. And now let's specify the URL for iOS. So here we have specified the contact here. So I have just specified the same text which we have specified for the Android URL also. So based on your device you need to launch them, so for which you need to know which platform you are currently. So you can just specify platform is iOS. So you need to specify the code over here, and else you can just specify the code for Android over here. So as we are making use of asynchronous method here, you need to test if await can launch. So here we have added a dependency, right, for URL launcher. So you need to make use of it. And here you need to specify iOS URL. So if it is true, then you need to specify await launch. You need to specify iOS URL. And also you need to specify here. So here you are trying to set the force Safari to false here, so that the URL will not be launched in your browser and it will make use of the application installed in your device. And else, so if your device doesn't have WhatsApp installed, then you need to specify. And if WhatsApp is not installed on your device, you can just make use of a print here. You can just provide here a toast or a snack bar also. I'm just trying to specify a print here to let you know what needs to be done in else part. So now let's try to copy this same, and now let's try to implement Android URL over here. And you need to launch Android URL here. We don't require this one for Android. And in the else, it's the same message again, WhatsApp is not installed. So you need to call reach us. When you tap on this particular button, you will be able to call this particular functionality here. And depending upon your platform, you can send the message from WhatsApp to this particular number here. And again, make sure you provide the exact number for which you want to receive the message from your users. And this is again a default message. You can customize this message according to your requirement. So now let's try to run this code and see the output. And also make sure here we have specified some dummy number. And when you are trying to run this code, you have to make sure you provide a number, and that number needs to be present on WhatsApp. That is, the number should be registered in WhatsApp. So now I will be trying to show you with a real-time number. You don't require any business account on WhatsApp for this, so even a normal account will work. So now I have specified some number here, and we can now able to see the WhatsApp for this account. Here you can see our screen is now open, and also you can see the message is being pre-written in our text box. So in this way, you can just integrate WhatsApp chat button in your application. So if you are having any queries in this tutorial, do let us know in the comment section below. And the code for this tutorial is available in the description section below. And if you like this tutorial, do like, share and subscribe to our channel for more interesting content on Flutter.